Hi everybody, it's Robin again from the RTNS studio. I'm here to do a really quick video. Excuse the sound from my little heater in here. It is so cold in this house. Not that the air is that cold outside, but it's so windy. So, you know, and this house is very well insulated, but once that wind picks up, you can't stop that wind from coming through every little crack and crevice. So anyway, I have something here I wanted to show. This is just a little, it was tags from St. Jude's Children's Hospital. If you give, if you support them in any way, even if you don't, I think, but my father used to, so now I have things coming here to my house. I did give at one time. They send you these little free gifts, notepads, and really cute drawings by the kids, and they make them into your little address labels. And so you get two sheets of those, and then the letter to you about them is also a full-size sheet like this that is actually sticker material on the backing. So rather than throw them away, we like to be green here a little bit, I had thought it would be a good idea to make some sticker paper. And the first thing I did was I had painted over with some black gesso just to cover up all the information. And then I don't know what my color choices here were originally, what this dull pink was. I don't know. I think I might have tried a, not Delusions paint, the ones with the dauber at the top, Distress, the Distress paints. And it just, I didn't like that shade, but rather than go through the other paints, I have three of the bright, these Posca pens, the pen markers. I can't remember exactly where I got these, but these write really nice. They dry, average time that most paint pens dry. That was just a glue stick there. So I finished up then using my Posca paint markers, and I did this. You know, the design's okay, but we're just cutting them up for little things here and there. I had used it in one of my planners as a separation, and I used it in a couple different things. So, but I thought it would be fun. I got some more, okay? I thought it would be fun to maybe do a do-along with you and make a couple sheets of them real quick. So that might be fun. And I think I might use some different colors. I'd like to have some maybe more pastel-y, like a light turquoise, a light yellow, a light pink, and maybe some gray even or something. Don't know for sure, but this is so cute. Look at. I can't show the address because it's for my son, but it's actually to this address here, so I didn't want to show that. But see, this is what they sent it. This is a whole piece also of this sticker paper on the, it's sticky on the back of this. So we're going to paint that too, but the kids did such cute little drawings. They did a butterfly, a kitty cat, ladybug, a dog, worm, inchworm, caterpillar, whatever. And then this is a little notebook that also came with it. And it has a little doggy and the cat. And I was playing around with my Xyron little sticker maker. And I actually, I don't know if you can see. No, and I don't want to mess with my tripod. I'm afraid to. But I took the, cut the doggy sticker out and put it on my sewing machine here. Just, I never, I'm not the type of person to stick stickers on things, you know. But I just thought it would be cute. So, let me get this ready real quick. I think what we'll do, what I'm going to do, is just this for now, just to cover that up. And wait, I'm going to tear this off. What was that? See, using my brain already. Oh boy. Actually, I'm doing this. It's pretty late at night, so here, I'll come out of frame here. And I guess we can just show on one. I have time to do others. But it's just kind of like doing the background on a journaling page, you know, an art journal page, I would imagine. Let's see. Do I want to use the black gesso again or some white gesso? What do you think? Let's see. I have something here. I kind of saved some of my supplies I was using the other day. This, if you can tell, I was using a glue stick. So I have a piece of paper here and I save it. So the next time if it's too sticky, just fold it over and use it again if I'm gluing things in a book or notebook or whatever. What do you want? You're staring at me.
Can I have some pot stickers?
Is that what they're called? Yes.
Okay. Yeah. I'm just making sure.
You want my Chinese food? Okay. Somebody says, "Oh, I like your conversation with your daughter." I told her she needs to be my sidekick, so maybe she can come in here and eat her Chinese and make comments while I'm doing this. Anyways, my glue thing, which I'm not gluing right now. And this was just, I found this somewhere, and I decided I would use it as a background paper. Instead of getting nice juicy colors all over my table, just for now, I'll just use this paper. And I cannot figure out a good setup for my tripod. It drives me up the wall. Right now I have it on my table aiming down. So if any of you are watching that have watched my other videos, just make a little comment. Let me know what you think of this angle. I'm comfortable as long as it doesn't get me in my belly and, you know, that kind of stuff. Okay, so how about we go with I have some golden fluorescent pink. I also have some golden teal. And I have some golden green gold. What do you think of these three? And then let's see, what else can we add to it? Well, I don't want to take too long. Let's see. That's a warm color too, cool colors. How about if we add kind of a little bit of a fluorescent? No, that's not bright enough. Orange, maybe? I think the orange. Okay, so let's start with the two cooler colors first. And what I'm going to do, guess what? I don't have my palette paper right there. But I do have a pink palette right here. Oh wait, here's some palette paper. I found it. And these were bigger. I cut them down trying to save. Let's see, is that one or two? Well, I'm going to cut it down. I had cut it down once already. I think they were like 11 by 13. You know, and unless I'm doing a huge portrait or portrait, big, big, huge picture, I don't think I need one that big. So there we go. And let's just take... medium-sized brush. Medium to small size brush. Medium to large size brush. I don't think it really matters what kind of brush we're using. It's a small area. We'll just use those. Now here's the problem with these being the fluid acrylics. The nice thing is they don't dry real fast, so they're really good for doing like gel printing. But the problem you have with them is it comes out so fast, you end up putting a little bit more down than you want to. So, you ready? I'm gonna go with the blue first. Oh yeah, see, I didn't put the gesso down, but we'll just hope that this will cover. There's no real pertinent information on this one. So, just dab it along. Sounds like Bonanza, I think. Okay. There we go. It's got that one there. Okay. Let me just blow on it a second. This stuff dries really fast. It's like blowing a trumpet. Okay. And just add a little green here and there. Oh, this is very, very, yeah, translucent. It is not covering up, but we'll see what we can do. I think it will be okay. I really do. We're just doing color first, and then I think we'll go and maybe use some little gadgets to put some marks on it here and there. How's that? Mix it in with that and get the rest of that stuff. Okay. This is my walnut ink stain I was using the other day on my... Valentine junk journal. I'll tell you what, it is hard to do that stuff because it's hard to peel. You use the skins and you boil the skins down from the black walnuts. And if you think, even think that you're going to get the meat out and have you some nice walnuts for free, think again. It is virtually impossible to get the meat or the nut out of black walnut shells without breaking them into 100 pieces. And I mean, it's really hard. Nothing like the regular English walnuts that you buy in the store to crack open and get the nuts out. Oh boy, yeah. That is why if you buy black walnuts at the store, they are $12.99 a pound or something, because it's just so, so impossible to get them out of the shell. It really is. Okay, now let's add a little bit of orange on top. I kind of wish I had a bigger brush. I should have just rinsed that one out, but let's go right here and see what happens. See, that's just not turning out, is it? I probably should have treated it first with the gesso. Well, let's see here. Just keep going. If it turns into mud or whatever, so be it. We'll just have some muddy sticker material to work with. I thought it'd be kind of fun just to do a little make-along. I think what I could do, though, is... I don't have that. All right. I shall use this dilution paint white and maybe just blend that here and there. Nope, looking like crap. Use the hands there, the hands. I think late night videos will not be my thing. Kind of afraid to open this because sometimes when you try too hard, yeah, it wants to splatter. Can anybody see what I'm doing? I'm way out of frame, aren't I? I may end up not using this video anyways. Well, let's see what happens. Let's do a little bright pink. You can still see a little bit of the other colors underneath. I might go back over it with some blue and then maybe... Don't know. I like the bright colors, so. Though. I'm gonna grab yellow. I want the yellow. Let's see. This is a Martha Stewart. The other ones were just like, well, these goldens. I got this in a kit I bought. It was golden A to Z, and you get little tiny samples of the paints, fluid acrylics, then you get some high flow, and then you get a couple other things, but then you also get in this, I think there's 32 pieces in this box, you get certain grounds, you get a ground like medium that you put over your paper if you don't have watercolor paper to do watercolors on. See, yellow's nice. And there's all kinds of different stuff. There's a paint extender that you can use to extend your paints so that they don't dry real fast, like if you wanted to do gel printing or anything like that. You know, I don't think this looks too bad, really. It's a little bit there. I might stick a little bit of this blue, and I've got my arm wrapped around my... Maybe I'll just grab it off of here. My arm is wrapped around the bottom of my... tripod. You know, when you want to make stuff look random, it just has this way of looking like you said, I want to put this here, 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 and here. But any other time... Okay, I'm just going to say that's done right there with that painting. But I'm going to get my white and maybe the black out also. And... we can do some circles on there with our little circle things, like caps and stuff. And if I have bubble wrap, which I know I do. Can use this. I have a brayer here that has what looks like bubble wrap. And then do some big circles. Okay. I got some stuff here. There we go. Hi, I'm still here. All right, black. I don't have a book here. Let's not waste paint. Do not waste your paint, people. Slap it on here. Oh, look at that. Oh my gosh, I splattered. Okay. I think I want to try some of the bigger circles. So I'm going to take this brush, just spread this around a little bit. And make sure I get all the areas. And let's do ta-da, ta-da, ta-da. Another one. There. I think that's all I want of the big circles. Let that dry a little bit. I'm going to find my little circle maker. There we go. Now, do I want to do smaller black circles or maybe some smaller white circles? I'll tell you, here's what I want to do. My hair dryer's on the floor. I had it in my little cabinet and it got bumped out. I'm going to put this on low, low. Put this on very low just to make sure this is dry. Having fun? My phone just let me know. Low battery. I may have to speed this one up. Okay, that's good. I'm going to put some white down, even if it's on the paper here. Paper. And run this through here. And let's do some there. That's cool. Except I want to turn it around. Oh, such is my pain. I don't have a lot of room on this table. Let's run one up to there. That looked good. Huh. There we go. That space in the middle is going to get me. Okay. I like to have these clean, so I'm just going to throw it in my paint water for now. Now I think I want to do this with the black dots. How's that? It probably probably won't make them too dark, and it won't make a lot, but I think it will add a nice dimension to it. So let's go through here. There we go. Yeah, I like it. But I just covered up all the white. So. Stop to scrub those good. Let's do one more thing. We still have some white left here. Let's do some of the white circles. And the edges and the corners. There we go. There we go. I think this will look pretty nice cut up. That paint's dried too much. There you go. It's not perfect. The colors aren't... But I think it's pretty good. So there you go. There's my first work along with me project. I was probably totally out of view and everything. And the video's kind of long. I don't even know if YouTube will let me upload it with it being this long. But if you like the video, please give me a thumbs up. And please subscribe if you're watching for the first time. Thank you so much. Bye, everybody.